Well, I would like to thank management, principal, and head of the department for giving me this opportunity to deliver the session to the learned participants. Today, I'm going to take a class on session on ICT tools such as Canvas, Google, and Loom. Before that, I would like to give my respect and gratitude to the soldiers who are all guarding the borders of our country, and the doctors, nurses, and the frontline workers who are all working 24/7 against the global pandemic, the corona COVID-19. So in today's course content is we are going to see about the Canvas instructure, Google Slide, generating automatic certificates using CertifyM, Loom add-on for Google Chrome. The course outcome will be, you will be able to create a course using Canvas. You'll know the required add-on for Google Forms, create and send certificates to the participants online by using CertifyM. And finally, you can create and send videos using Loom. We know that everyone has started exploring various online platforms that can be leveraged for live classes online. I would not say learning new tools is a cakewalk, but teachers also need a training plan to keep their morale high. We have taken attending a lot of webinars as how online teaching and learning can be made easy and glitch-free for both teachers and students. It looks and sounds promising, but we are yet to experience in firsthand. So now, in the pandemic world, the global pandemic, there is no other go for teaching. The only tool that we can reach the student is online tool. So what is the need of online education? Here I have given some points on online education. So it is the only way to deliver the knowledge during this global pandemic, and it is easy to reach the remote students, and it can provide continuing education to upskill the knowledge of the students. So what the research says, how can we achieve this? Because the usage of internet in India has been rise year by year. So as per the survey that has been taken in 2020, that is the current year, there are 730 million internet users, and there are 75% of new users from the rural area, and 75% new users to consume data in vernacular languages. That is many languages the internet has been used. And 83% mobile content has, video content has been shared. And 175 million people are using online shopping. And 70% e-commerce transactions are handled through internet. And 50% travel transactions will be in internet. So according to the global market of online education, Asia has been driven a lot, and it has been increased up to 18%, which has been driven by India, China, and Australia. So this is for general instruction, how we are growing and how the internet and how the facilities has been improved. So now we are going into the session. First, we are going to see about the Canvas. So the Canvas instructure. So Canvas instructure is a web-based learning management system, and the Canvas network, a massive open online course platform. So Canvas LMS is integrated student information system, video platform, professional development platform, content management system, and so much more. The platform is available for desktops as well as on mobiles. The platform is available on Apple, Microsoft, or Linux operating systems. So these are some of the features in the Canvas. So let me share these features through the slide, and we'll directly go to the demo session. Well, how can we use the Canvas like that? So these are the features of the Canvas. These things are going to be discussed in the demo session. That is collaborative workspace, recording or uploading the audio and video, integrated learning materials, web standard browsers, copy and paste link from the web browser, LTI integration, customizable contents, customizable user profile, open API, audio video messages, integrated tools, external services, shared resources, and so on. So the Canvas overcomes the limitations of the traditional learning systems. So first limitation is need for full-fledged LMS. If you need a full-fledged LMS, you can use this Canvas. The one of the advantage of using this Canvas is you can integrate this Canvas to your official college website also. That can be integrated, and you can plan the courses, and you can conduct the examination, and you can send the grades to the students through online by interconnecting your website with the Canvas. And second limitation is can't access timely data gathering. So what is this can't access timely data gathering? So nowadays students have a lot of works to do. They can go for the internship, they can go for the in-plant training, they can go for any other work. So during that time, the students may not able to study or follow the lectures that has been taken by the instructors and the professors. So the Canvas will give a platform to study all those things virtually through the LMS. And third one is one-dimensional learning limitation. That means in traditional learning system, the teacher will take the class, the student will listen, but the scenario has been changed. The students does not like the one-dimensional learning. So that this limitation is being overcome by using the Canvas. So let me directly go into the Canvas. So I'm going to open the browser. In the browser, type canvas.instructure.infrastructure. canvas.instructure.com. canvas.instructure.com. So when you enter into the canvas.instructure.com website, it will give you this screen. So if you have already an account, you can directly enter into the account by using your email and password. That is registered email and password. Another one thing is Canvas is free. Canvas is free for teachers and the students. If you are using for a college, there is a different pricing policy. So you have to discuss with the vendor, and then you can use the Canvas for your total college. But if you are using as an individual, you are creating a course for your own, it is free, and you can use it for free. So I have already created an account. Just I'm going to log in into my account. Let us wait. So this is the Canvas dashboard. So from here, there are a lot of things to do. You can create courses, and you can update your calendars, and many more things we can do with this Canvas. I have already created one course. Let me see. Let me show you how I have created, and I will show you how to create a new. Okay, so this is the course I have designed. The name of the course is Database Management System, that is DBMS. So these are the tags that has been given in this page. Each and everyone will get this tag. So you have to fill all these tags to create a complete course. So course in the sense, it means it may be a short-term course, or it may be a complete semester-wise course, or it's a long-term course. Okay, so it is up to you how you are going to design a course. So when you design a course, first thing you have to do is you have to go for your setting. So in setting, you will see the different tags that are available: course detail, section, navigation, apps, and feature options. So in that, so you can enter the course detail, what you are going to create first. Here I have given the name of the course as DBMS, course code is DBMS, and the time zone is Indian time. I have given the starting and ending time of the course, that is when the course will start at July 1st 2020 at 11 o'clock, and it ends at 31st August 2020 at 12 noon. And you have other features also, that is you can restrict the students from viewing this course after the end. Also you can restrict the students from viewing their course before starting date. And you have to choose the language and the file storage, which is typically given only 500 MB for each user. Now suppose if you are creating your course content must be within the 500 MB. Okay, it includes all the text materials, PowerPoints, audio, video, everything. So it should be below 500 MB only. And we can go for the more option. So on more option, here we have some other things that checkboxes are there. So let student attach a files for discussion, let student create discussion topics, let student edit or delete their own discussion post, and let student organize their own groups. So these things, whatever the thing you need, you can check it in the checkbox. Otherwise you can just leave it. So after doing that, you just update the course detail. Okay, so now I'm going into my account. In account, initially you have to fill all the details in your profile. Okay, so here is a profile. In this profile you can give all the details regarding you, that is who is going to create the, who is going to conduct this exam, and what are all the things to be followed, and biography of the course instructor. And you can also give the titles and URLs which already you have taken for the students. And this tag, so this tag, so in this tag you can have the files, and what are the files you need to handle the subject, and what are all the guided templates you need to have. These things you can upload here. And we go for the setting. So in the setting, so you have to fill all these details. And you have to give your exact email ID. The correspondence will be given, sent to this email ID. And the SMS will also send to this email ID. So once you completed your setting, the registration link will be sent to your mail ID with a 4-digit code. So you have to enter the 4-digit code and you have to click the registration link. Then only your account will get registered. Otherwise, your account will not get registered. So suppose if your account is not get registered, means you cannot use all the features that are available in this Canvas full-fledged. Okay, and also the Canvas supports some web services which can be attached. That means we can use the registered web services, that is Google Drive. You can take any content, and that content can be used here in the Canvas. And other services are also available. So these are the other registered services: Skype, Twitter, and Delicious. The Skype is used for performing the group communication, that is conference calls. We can make a conference call by means of Skype. I don't have the Skype account, so that I have not registered here. And these are all the some of the settings we will see later what are all the settings are there. Right. Set. Now we are going to see how the course is being created. So I have created a course. First, let me see the course. So this is the course. I have just created the course. So this course name is Database Management System. The course is divided into modules. So how a student can understand how many courses are there, how many modules are there, that can be given in the syllabus. So this is the syllabus, course syllabus. So whatever the content you have listed in your course, that can be given as a syllabus here. So you can edit the syllabus. If you want to show more things, you can edit the syllabus. Otherwise, you can just leave the syllabus. This is the syllabus editing screen. So you can edit here, and whatever the thing you want to add, you can add it into the syllabus. And after adding the syllabus, you just update the syllabus. Okay, so now you have created the course, and now the next thing you are going to do is you are going to add a module to the course. So I have decided to have 5 modules. So just I have added 2 modules. So how could we add a module? Just we have to use this module button. So just click on the module button. So you will have a module name. So you can add the module name, module 3. The name of the module is database design. So you can have a restriction on this module. That means you can set, if a student is assigned to a particular course, whether he can access all the modules at a time, or otherwise he have to access the module one by one. So by clicking this checkbox, you can do that. So this is the unlock. So you have to select the date, so when the course has to be unlocked. Okay, so I am setting that the course has to be unlocked on July 26th. Okay, and the time 11:59. So the course will be get unlocked at 11:59. And you can add the prerequisites for the course module. So what are the prerequisites for this module? You have, that is, for database design, you must know the introduction of SQL. So after doing this, you can just add the module. See. So we have the module at the bottom. Okay, we have a module at the bottom. So once you have created the module, you have to publish the module to view. Otherwise, you cannot view the module. So here is a button, that is cross button. That is when you go, you can see the mouse pointer, that is publish. So when you click the button, it will turn into green. That means the module is being published. Okay, so once it is published, you can view the module. So next thing, after doing that, you have to add the content to that module. So here Canvas allow you to add several contents, like files, and you can add a video, or you can give a link, or you can directly present your video into this Canvas. You can give assignments, and you can give links to the quiz, and whatever you want to add to this module, you can do it. So first I am going to add a file. Okay, so these are the files which I have already added here. So if you want to add a new file, click on the new file. So click on the new file here. You have to choose one file. Now I'm going to add a file just for an example. It's a PowerPoint slide. I'm just adding the PowerPoint slide to the file. Okay. So to which folder you are going to add this one? You are going to add it in a course file. So leave that, don't indent, and then click on add item.
Raghav, if possible, just zoom the page.
But it's not visible.
Somewhat it is not visible.
Sir?
Somewhat it is not visible.
Sir, is it not visible to the audience?
Yes. The page was not clear. Zoom, a little bit zoom.
So it is not able to zoom. Let me check what we can do. Is it okay now? Sir, is it okay now?
Okay.
Yeah, okay.
Okay. Right. So now we have included a again video file to this module. So already I have given a video file. So I'm going to add this video file to this module. Just clicking and opening it. It will take some time to load this video. So that is why it's get delaying. So you can see the data has been loading. Yes, so data has got loaded. Again, the same file I have chosen, I think so. Okay. Okay. So like that, you can include any number of files regarding this module, and you can also add the assignments. So you can add an assignment. So click on the new assignment. Assignment name. The assignment name maybe suppose. So I'm just giving the name as PT1. Can add the assignment here. Okay, the assignment is added here, but the content of the assignment has to be filled using this assignment tag. Okay. So until we are published, unpublished, the viewers cannot see all those assignments and the content. So now we have added, right? Okay. Now we have added. So next thing we are going to see here is an announcement. So the announcement tab is used for making the announcement that are visible to the user. Okay, so you can make any number of announcements regarding the discussion or regarding the starting of the class or when you are going to the assignment. So the such kind of things can be included in your announcement. So here I have already given an announcement important detail on course. So what announcement I have given is the course will start on 5/7/2020. Suppose I want to create a new announcement, means I can just create a new announcement just by clicking this plus symbol button. So you can choose the topic of an announcement. This topic of the announcement is assignment. Okay? Assignment. So I am going to give a message on that announcement. The students are requested to attend the assignment without fail. Without fail. So after typing that, you can give an option. That is whether the announcement is just for reading purpose or it can be replied by the students. That is up to you. If they want to, if you need a reply from the student, you can check the box allow user to comment. Otherwise, you just leave the box. The student can, who are all registered for this course, can directly come and view the announcement. Suppose if I am checking the box, means they can give a comment on that assessment, announcement, sorry. Okay, so I have posted a new announcement. The students are requested to attend the assignment without fail. Okay, so next is assignment. Next one is assignment. So you can create any number of assignments. So here I have created assignments. So lastly, I have created an assignment for the module 3. The name of the assignment is PT1. So where I have created in the module, it is reflecting in the assignment tab. So I'm just clicking on the assignment. Let me see what are all the things you can see. So nothing will be seen because I have not assigned anything to that assignment. So what I am going to do is I'm going to add an assignment. Just click on this three dots. Okay, so I'm going to edit, right? So what is the due date of the assignment? I have already given the name PT1, and what is the due date of the assignment? So since we are starting the course, assignment date is 26, and I am making the assignment due date as 30, and the time. Done. So how many points you are going to give for that assignment? Here, the mark and the grades for the student is given as a points. That is, it ranges from 0 to 5, or it may be ranges to 0 to 3. It's up to you how you are going to design your course. So here are the more options. You can click on the more option. So you can give the description about the assignment, what you are going to do with the assignment, and what you should do. I'm going to type the question, what I am going to give for an assignment. Okay, so design a database for hospital management system. Okay, design a database for hospital management system. This is the assignment I'm going to give. The maximum points for the assignment is 5. Assignment group, you can have a group assignment also. If there are number of students, you can separate the students into group, and you can assign the assignment for individual assignment for each group. And display the grade as points. So we are going to give a point so that the grade will also displayed as a point. Submission type, you can type the assignment as online or on paper or external tool. So whatever the thing, whatever the mode you want your student to submit the assignment, you can choose here, either online, on paper or external tool. So I'm just giving online. So online, you can choose the file recording. That is, the student can create the file for that assignment, and then they can upload the file by using this link. So you can also restrict the uploading file types. So you just type PDF. I accept only PDF file so that I'm restricting the uploading file type as PDF. So this is not a group assignment, so don't want to check it. If it is a group assignment, you have to check it. Peer reviews required. If you want to, if your peer reviewing is required, you can give the check the box. Anonymous grading. Students cannot view the student grades cannot be viewed student names. Okay, graders. That is, who are all going to give? Who are all going to give the grade? Cannot view the student name. Without viewing the student name, they can give the give the grade. Means you can check it. Otherwise, you just you don't check it. And then for whom you are going to assign? So this is we are going to assign for the entire students who are all registered for the course, so that you check it as everyone. And what is the due date of the assignment? We have already checked. And when the assignment is available? At what time and when the assignment will be available? So the assignment will be available on 26th July, and the assignment will be available until 30th. Okay, so after doing all these preliminary steps for assignment, you can just save it. Okay, so we have saved all the assignment. And without student, we cannot conduct the class, right? So adding the student is more important. Here, it can be done with the help of the people tab. So just you can click on the people tab. See, I have already added some students. So if you want to add new set of students, means you can just click this plus people button. The box will open. So by using this box, you can add the students. The only method used to add the student is you can invite them to attend the course. Okay, so there are three modes. One is email login, email address, login IDs, and SIS ID. Email is most probably preferable, because we will all have the email IDs of the students. So you just keep all the IDs in your Word document, and just copy the ID and paste it here. And after pasting that, you can just call them back. Okay, so already I have sent some invitation to the other IDs. So after giving the IDs, what will happen, I will show you now. So you can also set the invitation for what is the role of the person you are inviting, whether the person you are inviting may be a student, he may be a teacher, he may be a teaching assistant, he may be a course designer, or he may be a observer. And for what section you are going to assign. Suppose you have created a course and there are more number of students. If you want to separate the student into different section, means you can separate the student into different sections. So that sections will be available here when if you created already. Okay, So now I have already sent on request. Just I am sending it again. That is raghavsham@gmail.com. So I know the person name. I know the ID of the student, so that I am sending an invitation to that student. So participant, please remember that the both the student and the teacher who are all going to participate in the Canvas must have their valid user account. So without using the without having their user account, they cannot use this LMS platform. Okay, so just I am giving you a next, adding the people. Okay, so we are not unable to match below. Why? Because the user is not available already in the LMS platform. Suppose if it is available in the Canvas, means it will show you the name. Now it is not available, so I am going to give the name. That is name of the student is Raghav J. So just after doing that, you just click on the next button. Okay, so email following user are ready to add it to the course. Just add the user. Okay, so we have added. So see here, when you click on the tab, it will show you how many students are there. Here we have totally five users. One is myself, the teacher, and other four are the students. Two of them have already registered for the course, and two of them invitation is pending. So I will show you how we can enter into the course. Okay, so this is the invitation that I have sent to the particular person, raghavsham@gmail.com. So after getting the invitation, you have to just click on the get started button. It will navigate you to the Canvas website. Okay, so it is directly it take you to the Canvas website into the particular course. Okay, you can see the course and modules here. These are the modules we have created so far. After doing that, after getting after coming into the site, you just click the button accept. Suppose you already have your account, then you can go with I have an Canvas account. Otherwise, the student has to create their own account. So just click on create my account. So you have to set a password for that. Yes, and the time zone. Time zone. So you have to set a time zone, Chennai. Yeah, it's here, Chennai. Okay, so I want to receive information and news, and I agree the user policy. Then register. Right. So now the Raghav has been registered for the course. So here we have he can see the course detail completely, and he can see whatever the things that are available for him, and he can also see the announcement. He can see the announcement. See, so we have created the announcement. The students are requested to attend the assignment without fail. Suppose if the student want to reply for this announcement, he can directly click on the reply button. And he can reply it. Okay, so post the reply. He can the reply has been sent. So coming into the teacher's login. I'm just going out and coming inside so that I can see whether the person has added to the course or not. See, has been added. So total activity, how much time he is using the platform for studying. So here you can see that Shamila, the student has used only 9 minutes 36 seconds, and Raghav is still open. As far as he is using about 2 minutes 4 seconds. You can monitor all the student activities from here, whether they are using, how much time here they are spending in learning process, and everything you can monitor from here itself. And the next thing we are going to see here is the discussion. So discussion forum, you can call the students for a discussion. You can post any topic for the discussion, and the students who are all willing to participate in the discussion, they will come. You can also add this discussion to the grading system also. Suppose how much they have participated, how often they are coming into the discussion. Based on that, you can give grade points for the students. Many foreign universities and online courses are giving a minimum grade point for the discussion also. So I have created already a discussion on discussion here. What is the discussion? It's data models. The students who are want to make a discussion on data models, or they want to share their knowledge, they can directly come and share their knowledge in the discussion forum. So here students should discuss their views about the data models. Okay, so I have sent all the invitation to all the students. So let me see, let me show you how we can create a discussion. So just click on the plus button. Okay, so here what is the discussion topic? Discussion topic is database design, and then what you are expecting for the discussion from the student, you can write here. Students are requested to discuss about creating good database using the normalization technique. Using the normalization technique. Using normalization technique. The best solution will be so where to post. So you have to post it for DBMS. Suppose if it is having any attachment, you can attach it. And if you want to make it as a group discussion, you can make it as a group discussion. And the availability of the discussion, when you are going to discuss availability, you have to mention the availability. We can make it available on 31st July, and it will be available until August 1st, and you have to mention the time. Then you just click on the save and publish. So suppose if you do not publish the assignment, discussion, anything else, means it cannot be viewed by the students. Only it will get viewed when you click on the publish button. Okay, so now it is get published, and you can see it. So you can see it here. So you have created a discussion forum for database design. So database design, the discussion is not available until 31st July at 0:00. So after that only it is available, sir. Okay, shall I continue, sir? Okay, thank you. Okay, so now let me see what happens in the student login. So just in the student login, I click on the discussion. See, the discussions are available here. So the only discussion available is data models, because the data models is already available. It is until 5th of July. So you can click on the discussion forum, and you can give your reply here. Object relational data model is best one. Best for real time applications. Object relational data model is best for real time applications, and I'm posting the reply. Okay, it is already, it is showing here. Again, I can see the same thing on the discuss forum. So the one thing, the discussion forum is viewed by all the students. So if every student is participating in the discussion, each one's reply will be shown here. That is, every student can see the reply of other students. Data model. See, one student have given a reply. So the student's reply is here. You can also give reply for the student's idea. And next thing is pages. Next thing is the pages. So you can add a page for your courses. So whatever the page you need, you can add it here. I have added a page called a database. So it directly goes to the database course, and it will show you the content that you have already given in that course. Okay, next is a file page, file tag. In file tag, you can upload as much amount of files which are used in your course. Okay, completely you can add all the files to that file tags, so that the student can directly come into the files and click on the file. They may be able to download the file whatever they require. Suppose if you are uploading the PDF file or a PPT file, means if they want, they can download it from the website directly from the LMS itself. This is fine. So let me show you in the student login. So I just want to go click on the files. So here we have a lot of files are there. I need a file that is database DBMS unit 1. I just click on the DBMS unit 1. Thank you. Okay, you can see the course material, database management system, unit 1, and the content of the file. Everything you can see it here itself. The students who want to learn this thing, you can directly come and learn from the file itself. If you want to open the PPT, the Canvas will support you to open the PPT there itself. See, I have given an introduction PPT here. Just I'm clicking on the PPT. The PPT will be shown here. It is taking some time to load. I think there is a problem in the PPT, it seems. Let me try another one. So here are the recordings. I have added the recording of that. The media will get open here. Yes. You can see the video. This video tutorial of database management system. Suppose you are having your own video, you can directly add it to your module. Suppose if you want to give link to the database management system module in especially NPTEL videos or some other videos, you can give the link. Okay, so this is a NPTEL video module, so it will be open. New window, it will ask you for open a new window. Just click on that, it will directly redirect you to YouTube. It's loading, network is very slow, I think so.
What does AI mean for business leaders and for business?
Okay, everyone is viewing that, yeah, the video is.
How can right? it be converted into value and opportunity?
So I close that video. And the student can also view the assignments and who are all in the classes and discussion forum pages, files. And last thing, how can we make a quiz? How can we make a quiz? So I'm clicking on the quiz tab. Here you can create your own quiz. So I have already given a quiz, and this quiz is taken as an assignment. So when the student appears for this quiz, the mark will be added to the grade. Okay. Suppose if you want to add a new quiz, you can click on the add quiz button. So you have to name the quiz. Have to name the quiz. SQL quiz. SQL quiz. So in this text box, you can give the instruction for the quiz. How many questions will be there? How should you answer the question? What type of questions will be there? So those instructions you can give it in this window. and then you have to choose the quiz type, whether it is a grade quiz or it is a graded survey, it's an ungraded survey. So probably we use a grade quiz. And what type of quiz it is? It is whether it is going to take as an assignment or not. Yes, it is assignment. And you can also choose an option. That is, you have to shuffle the answer or not. If you want to shuffle the answer for each and every participant, every student, you can just click on the shuffle answer. And you can set a time limit for the quiz. How much time you need. That is, it's up to you. How we are creating our quiz based on the quiz, you can assign the time. So I am assigning 20 minutes for a quiz. And whether the student is allowed to apply multiple times. If you want to, if you want your student to attend the quiz for multiple times, you can check the box. Otherwise, you just leave it. And then these box will get already checked in default. Let students see the quiz response. It will be marked in the incorrect questions will be marked in the student feedback. That is, once the quiz is over, when he submitted the quiz, he will get the proper response, whether the quiz is correct or not, like that. And then last one is, let students see the correct answer. Suppose you want to see the correct answer, you can mark the correct answer in the question, and then the question, the correct answer will be get displayed. The student will see the correct answer after submitting the quiz. So when should we show the correct answer? You can set the time limit for the quiz. So it is based on the time, at the maximum time where when we can give the correct answer. So I am setting it at 31st July. If you want to hide the correct answer, means you can hide it. Otherwise, you can just leave it off. Okay. So if the quiz should show the continuous question, means you just leave it out. Suppose if the page should contain only one question at a time, means you have to check on the box, show one question at a time. And question restriction, if the student had to attend the quiz based on the access code that was created by you, means you have to check the box that is require an access code. Otherwise, you can left it out. Okay, due date, when we are going to start the quiz. We are going to start the quiz on day. And at what time it is available from? Today, 12:10. It is available from 12:10 until tomorrow. Yes, done. So you have also some other things. So to which course we are going to assign this quiz, you can just click on the DBMS, right? So it is assigned to DBMS. That means it's section. The whole section will attend the quiz. Everyone can attend the quiz, so that we are assigning the section name to the quiz. Okay. So after completing everything, you just click on save and publish. Okay. So we have created the quiz, but we have not entered any questions into the quiz. So just again, you go to the edit. Here, the question tag is here. So you just click on the question tag, click on the new question. So what type of question you are going to give it to the student, either this multiple choice question or true or false, fill in the blanks, multiple answers, drop downs, matching, numerical answers, formula question, essay questions, file upload questions, and text. So whatever the type you want, you can assign to the question. So I have chosen a multiple choice and I have given a point one for the question. So here I'm going to type the question. The question is, what is SQL? So I have to give the answers. The correct answer is structured query language. Structured query language. So the possible answer is that question language, structured query language, and structured. So once a question is given, we just update the question. So if you have entered all the question, you just save it. So you have given the question and the student can view it in the quiz. So if they want to go for a quiz, just click on the quizzes. So here we have questions. Okay, the question is, first DBMS questions available until 6th June, due date is 6th July. Two questions are there. The SQL question is single question and it is available today and tomorrow. So I'm just clicking on it. I'm just take question. So these are the instructions we have set it. So the answer is structured query language. So I'm submitting it. Okay. So I have chosen the incorrect answer. So let me see what grade I have taken. So to see the grade I have taken, I have to go to the teacher's login page. So in that, I click on the grades. I click on the grade. So I just want to see what is the grade I have taken. So this is the grade I have taken DBMS. Grade is zero. Okay. I have taken the grade. The grade is zero. I can also see the course average and course median through this. I can see the individual courses of individual all the students here, and I can also see the progress here. So once the course is being completed, I can view all the grades that are automatically given. I have assigned already. That grades will be displayed in this boxes. Let me show you how to add these things. So here we have an outcomes. So first we have to set an outcome for each one. So we have two types of thing. One is quiz and assignment. So first for a course, we have set an outcome. So the outcomes mastery point is 3. Here we have given a calculation method that is decaying average. So the decaying average is the last taken quiz will have the highest point, and the least taken, that is the first taken quiz, have the lowest point. That means the grade will get automatically increased one by one. That is called as a decaying average. Here we have some other schemes also. Suppose if you want to change the scheme of grading your students, you can just change it by clicking on the edit button. You can change it. So here we have three types of n number of times, how many number of times they have attended, how many time number of times they have visited the course, and most recent score and highest score. Based on these things, you can calculate the grade of the student. So once you assigned all these course outcome, just you can save it. Suppose you have, if you have already have a outcome designed previously, means you can insert that one also. It is also possible. So how could we insert it? Just edit it and go to the criterion rating. You can insert it how much you want. Likewise, you can. And for quiz also, we have given the grade point. Are they the same calculation method is decaying average method. And also we can set for the rubrics. So rubrics means how much point you are going to give, maximum point for an assignment. Suppose how many assignments you are going to give, how many assignments the student has to be attend. So these things we can give it in the rubrics. And if you want to add more number of rubrics, suppose if you have more number of method for analyzing the students, especially like projects, mini projects, for that you can assign the rubric points for that. So for assigning that one, you have to press on add button, add rubrics. It will open it, and you can set what for what you are going to add the rubrics, and you are going to set the range of the rubrics, how much point, how much point you are going to set it. So likewise, you can set it. And next thing is a collaboration tab, conference tab. The conference tab, which is used to make a video conferencing with the students, you can create a conference and you can schedule the time. So during that time, the student can approach the faculty or a teacher or a tutor to clear their doubts. So that is the called as conference. So I have already created a new conference, that is DBMS conference. It's in progress. The main aim of the conference is, if you want any clarifications in assignment, we are ready to clarify it during the office hours. Only the office hours, the student can call and clear their questions. Suppose if you want to add a conference, means you can click on the button. So what is the name of the conference? You can name the conference something else like SQL. So the conference type is Big Blue Button. So Big Blue Button is another one platform which is default with the Canvas. So that is it is a third party vendor platform. It is like a communication tool. Suppose if you already I have shown that there is a Google services for Canvas, in which I have clicked on the Google services, and the left side, the right side, I have shown you the Skype and some other else. Suppose if you are having a ID for Skype, you can directly add the Skype. Suppose if you added the Skype, then it will appear in this type. Skype will appear in this type. You can directly give it give the type of the communication, and the duration is 60 minutes. You can set the duration for how much time you want. You can set it. Suppose if you want to record this conference, means you can record it. It will automatically record the conference. And if it is no time limit, means you can check this and you can give the description about the conference. Students can discuss about. SQL, okay, and just you update it. Okay, so it will get updated. Suppose you want to start, means you just click on the button start button. It will redirect you to the third party vendor site. So to use this, you should have the user license for this particular communication tool. Okay, right. So next, again, we are going to go for the setting. So whether all these tabs can be viewed by the student or not, so that you can manage it. You just go to the navigation. So in navigation, you can drop and change all these one. One thing I have left it, that is attendance. It is very important for the student to grade it. So I'm just dragging it and keeping it in another tray. Here are the outcomes, grades, rubrics, and new analytics. So these things will be hidden from the student. So now I am saving it. You can see the attendance tab here. You just go into the attendance tab. It will show you the students here. Suppose if the students has logged in, you can give the attendance to the student. Otherwise, you can just keep them unmarked. So here we have five students are there. So you can mark the attendance here for today. Okay. So yesterday there is only one student attended, so that I have given attendance for that student. For today, I am going to give attendance for three students. So three of them have attended the classes. Okay. So no, don't want to save anything else. You can just go out of the tab and you can see it. Okay. Again, I'm going into the setting tab. So in setting tab, so here we have a section. That is already I have told, no, once you created the course, suppose if you have more number of students, means then you can separate the student into different section. So here you can create a section. So by clicking the plus button, so if you click the plus button, it will automatically go into the section creation. So you can create a section, you can name the section and you can create the section. And here are the apps. These are the external apps. Suppose you want these apps, you can install it here. Okay, so there are n number of apps are available. Suppose these apps are necessary for your particular course, then you can select on that app and you can install it, so that the student can use this app while they are using the while they are studying the courses. Okay, there are more number of apps are there, Dali Dictionary, Britannica, like that. More number of apps are there. So if you want to have add any apps, you can directly add. So this is a future option. What are all the things you need? You can directly view it. What are things you can you want? You can check it here. So I want a learning mastery gradebook, student learning mastery gradebook, and allow outcome extra credits. So these things I have checked here. Okay, I think these are all hidden. I think so. Yes, grades are hidden here. Analytics. Okay, the new analytic is a analytical tool. Yesterday I have initiated the tool. It requires 24 hours to get applied in your LMS platform. So still now it is not 24 hours, I think so. That is why it is showing that course data is being processed. Please come back in 24 hours. So I'm going to the grades. I have already shown this, I think so. So you can also view the grade book. So here it will show the complete grade book of all the students. You can see it, how many points, how many marks they have got. Attendance, see, I have given attendance for three of them. So today they have a 100% attendance, and how many quizzes they have attended. Two quizzes out of two have been attended, one quiz, one is attended. And you can also export this. So you can export this. So when you export, it will be stored as downloaded as a CSV format, Excel file. Yes. So here it has been downloaded. You can see that. I'm opening that file. You can also send these grades to the students through mail also. You can directly send the individual list to the mail through the mail. So here is the canvas. Here is the canvas report. So what is the section the student is studying, roll call, and how many quizzes he have attended, and what else? It is assignment. Here is another one, assignment, SQL quiz, and what are all the marks, whether they have visited all these things. When they visit each and when they click on each link in the module, it will get initiated, and it will also record how much time the user is being there. So based on that, it will award the mark automatically. Okay, you can also view individual view. You can view the individual view of the student. Suppose I want to view the data of Sharmila. You can view it. All the information will be available here. Select a section. So you can also download the current score of the individual person also. Okay, so I have completed the first tutorial on the canvas. So next we pass on to the next tool. So audience, if you have any question, please put it in the chat box. I'm ready to answer for that after the session is over. So now let me show you the next tool we are going to see, that is Google Form. So everybody know that Google Form is one of the important tool used nowadays for online education. Okay, Google Form. So Google Form is a tool that allow collecting information from the user via a personalized survey or quiz. The information is then collected and automatically connected to the spreadsheet. The one of the main advantage of using this Google Form is you can export the data to the spreadsheet. So here I'm going to discuss about some of the important add-ons which are required for the Google Form. So why I'm concentrating on the Google Form is because nowadays, we are evaluating the students by means of conducting the quiz through Google Form. So for conducting the quiz, we need some important three add-ons. So So one is email notification for forms, an advanced summary for awesome tables, and last one is a certified M. So I'll show you the live demo of all these things. So first I am entering into the Google Drive. So I have already created the quiz. I have created the quiz on DBMS. Suppose you want to create a new quiz, means then you just go and press the new button. In that, you click on Google Forms. You click on the Google form. Yes, you have created. So first you have to name the form. So for what purpose we are using this form? Maybe it is used for a quiz. Example. Canvas quiz. Okay. The name of the form is Canvas. There is no need to store this form because Google will automatically save all the content whenever you change in your form, and you are going to the same file name will be given to the form title, and you can give the description of the form, whether who is going to create, who have created the form, who is going to organize this quiz program, and what is the starting date of this quiz, and when the quiz will end. So these kind of information can be given here. So I am giving that conducted by Department of Computer Science and Engineering. Department of Computer Science and Engineering. Organizer. Here are Associate Professor. CSE. And the date. This date 2/7/2020. This date is up to you whether you want to post. You will select the date on which you are going to conduct the quiz. So that day you can be given here. Okay. So next is an options we are going to give here is whether initially in Google form. The first thing will be the name of participant, right? So name of the participant. Name of the participant. The name of the participant is, the question is what type of answer the user has to give. It is a short answer because they have to enter it so that it is short answer text, and this field is mandatory, so you have to check it. Okay. Then next is, if you want to add another question, you just click on the plus button. Okay. Plus button. Second is you are getting the college name. College name. It is also a short answer. And in this field is also required. And the third is department. Suppose multiple departments are participating in this event, means you can choose the drop down box here. So here we have a lot of choices to enter the question and answer. So here we are I'm going to use the drop down box. So in the drop down box you can give the answers like CSE. If you want to add another option, means ECE, EEE, mechanical, civil, BA, MCA, so on. So how many number of departments are there? If you want to add anything, you can. And then again, you make it as required field. The next thing is we are going to add up questions. Okay. So question normally be a multiple choice question. The multiple choice question, in the sense, if you choose multiple choice, means only one answer will be there. Suppose if the question has more number of answer, means you can use the checkbox. Otherwise, if your student want to answer or they have to write it their own answer, means you can choose short answer or paragraph. So my choice will be a multiple choice question. The first question is, what is BMS? Option one, collection of metadata data. Option two, collection of related data. Option three, collection of external data. And option four, none of the above. So this is my first question. So I'm just adding it, multiple choice question. And if you want your student to attend all the question, means you just click on the required button, so that the student cannot skip the question. They will compulsorily attend all the questions. Suppose if you want to delete the question, means you can delete it. You can, if you want to duplicate the question, means you can duplicate it. The purpose of the duplication is the second question is same as the first question. That is a multiple choice question, means you can set like that one. So for that purpose, we can use duplication. So just for a sake, I am using, creating this Google form to let you know how to create the Google form. Next thing is we are going into the setting of this Google form. Okay, so here is the setting. So just press the setting. Suppose you want to collect all those email IDs. Suppose you need email IDs of all the students who are all participating in this quiz maze. You have to click it on the collect email ID. Okay, and if the student want to attend the question only once, means you can limit to one response. Otherwise, it will ask for the next one. Third one is respondents can edit after submit. Suppose once the student is submitted all the questions, then if you are showing the right answer, means then the student, it is possible for the student to check the correct answer again. Suppose if you click on this choice, means edit after submit, the student can edit the answer after he has submitted. And then here you can also see the summary chart, how much questions, how far he have attended, and everything you can see through this summary chart. And next is the quizzes. You have to assign point value for the quiz. So without point, we cannot conduct the quiz. So we have to assign the point value. You can given a chance that, so once the question has been attended, immediately the point will be given to the quiz. Otherwise, if you want to manually give the points, mean you can manually give the point, so that for that you can check the later after manual review. So most probably nowadays quizzes are giving the points immediately, so that you check this, you click on this radio button, that is immediately after submission. Okay, so next thing is the presentation. If you want to show the submit the button. That is, you are allowing the student to submit another response. That is, one person has been submitted and another person want to submit means you can click on this checkbox. Otherwise, you can just uncheck it. Suppose if the student the questions and answers should be shuffled means you can click on the shuffle question order. It will automatically shuffle all the questions. So after completing that, you can save that. Okay. So I have saved all these all the things the settings regarding the quiz. And next thing is how could we validate the question and answer, because every question has given a grade. Okay. So how can we add the grade to the question means you have to click on the answer key. Okay. Click on the answer key. How many points you are going to give this question? So I'm going to give 2 points for this question. What is the correct answer for this question? Okay. So collection of interrelated data. So even if you shuffle the question, the answer will not get shuffled, so that the Google will automatically calculate the grade for all the questions. Okay. So once you finished it, you can just click on done. So I am clicking it, click on done. So I have created the Google form with one question now. So I can see whether the Google form is being created or not. I'm just clicking on the preview. See preview. Here email address field is there. We have not created any email address, but when you click on the setting, we checked on the collection of email address, so that the email address field is automatically present here. So the first field will be the email address field, and the next field is department and the name of the participant, college name, and then finally the question. Okay. So when you choose the department, it will give a drop down box. You can check on the department you want to choose. You can choose it. Okay. Suppose if you want to submit here, means it will not get submitted because all the star marked fields are mandatory. So without these are all the required fields. So without filling those fields, you cannot submit the form. Okay. So just I'm coming out of the form. Just leave it. And also, whatever the field you have created here, the Google will create a response as a spreadsheet for that. So here is the response spreadsheet. You can see here. So here is a button. When you click on this button, the responses that has been captured by the Google form will be converted into Google spreadsheet, and you can download it. And it can be used for further clarification or something on a personal use. You can use it. So next, coming into the add-ons. Next, coming into the add-ons. Here we are going to see three add-ons. The first add-on is email notification for the Google form. So what is the use of this email notification? The email notification is used to limit the number of Google forms, that is submission of number of Google forms. You can limit it. Suppose if your class is having only 50 students, suppose you are getting a response of 60, means that is some of the students have repeatedly answered the questions, right? So that to limit that, you can check it for only 50 students, that is 50. And the limitation can be set when the quiz is enabled, at what time the quiz will be enabled, and what time it will end. Those things we can have it. So for that, you have to click on the limit form responses. Limit form responses. The setting will be open here. Limit Google form responses. So for this form, when we are going to start this Google form today, okay, so 2:07. And the time is 12:45. When it will get closed, it will close on 2. Time is 1:00. Okay. Suppose if you have more number of entries, suppose if you have 50 entries, means it will automatically turn off. So whatever comes first, it will turn off. Suppose 1:00, it ends it. It reaches 1:00, means it will close. So before 1:00, if there is 50 entries, means it will get closed. Whichever comes first, it will close first. So after doing that, you just save it. So we have saved it. Okay, we have saved it. And then I'm just going into the preview. So I have already seen the preview for this quiz, so that it is not allowing me to entering into the quiz. So once you created the quiz, you can send the quiz link to the students. So you can just give an email ID, then directly you can publish this quiz to the email ID. You can send the quiz to the email ID. Otherwise, you can just copy the link here and paste the link to the WhatsApp group or whatever else the social media you want to share the quiz, you can give it. So once the link is clicked, it will directly redirect to the quiz and the quiz will get executed. And I will show you the advanced summary by option table with another quiz. Let me show you. So DVMS unit 1 quiz. So this quiz is already conducted by me for the students. So totally how many responses are there? 25 responses. Suppose I want to know how many students has been attended, because I have set it as a manual evaluation, so that score will not be available. Let us go to another quiz. This is not the quiz. Okay, so let me show you the add-on. Advanced summary by awesome table. So just click on that. You will get a pop-up window. So you just click on create advanced summary. The work is in progress. So the advanced summary will generate the charts. Whatever the thing you need, you can check here. You want to see everything, you can click on all the fields. I have given 10 questions. So to view the advanced table, you have to log in. So I log in with my ID. Just click on allow. Okay, I can see the summary of the quiz. So who are all attended the quiz? The names will appear here. Email IDs, department, top result, how many questions they have attended, and what is the chart for each question. How many of them have answered the questions correctly? Nearly 95.8% have attended, clicked the conceptual view, and 4.2% have clicked the external view for the first question. So like that, for each question you can see the summary. See, you can see the summary. So this is the use of advanced summary in add-on in Google Form. Okay, so let me show you the another add-on. It is called as Certify-M. So how can we add this add-on to your Google Form? Just click on the three dots in the top right corner of your screen and go to the add-ons. So click on the add-on. So it will show you some set of useful add-ons. So whatever the add-ons which are required for your form, you can choose it. So for creating these kind of exams, you need three types of add-ons. The three types of add-ons are email notification and advanced summary and Certify-M. So when you install it, it will show like this. It is installed already. Suppose if it is not installed, means it will ask you for installation. You just have to click on the installation for that. So I will finish it shortly, that time is running out. Okay. So next I'm going to show you how to create online certification with the help of Certify-M. With the help of Certify-M. So I have already created a quiz for that. I will show you very shortly and fastly how to create the certification. Just I have click on the quiz. Quiz on DBMS. Unit 1. Still loading. Okay, it is loaded. So if you want to create a online certificate, means you have to install the Certify-M add-on to that your Google Drive. So first click on the Certify-M. It will show you the control box of the Certify-M. You just click on show Certify-M controls. Show Certify-M controls. So the Certify-M control add-on is used to generate automatic certificates, predefined certificates. So these certificates can be created by your own, or you can use the templates which are available in the Certify-M add-on itself. So initially, the status of the Certify-M will be, if you are clicking it for first time for your particular course, means it will be, the certification is off. It will show you the status, certification is off. So you have to turn it on. So when you turn it on, it will come like this. And for whom you are going to give certificate, suppose the passport percentage is 40 and above, you can use the certificate, means then you can give the pass percentage here. So here are the pass percentage. Suppose if you want to increase the pass percentage, means you can increase it. Suppose I want to increase the pass percentage at 60, means I can increase it. And then template. So here in Certify-M, we have many number of templates available. You can use those templates just by clicking on the preview. You can see how many certificate designs are available in Certify-M. This is a certificate template. You can directly use this type of templates for giving certificates to your students. So here here are the some set of certificates are there. You can use it. Otherwise, if you want your own custom certificate, means you can use your custom made certificate. I will show you how to create a custom certificate and how to use this certificate also. So suppose if you are using a custom made, if you want to use a custom made certificate, then click on the template and there will be a use a custom template. You click on the custom template. So for using a custom template, you have to already create a certificate, and that certificate should be stored in a Google Slide, and that should be stored in a Google Drive. So then only you can use the certificate. I have already created a certificate using a Google Slide. So I will show you how I have created that one. So this is the sample certificate I have created. So just I'm clicking on the certificate and selecting the certificate. And finally, I'm clicking on the save changes. CertifyM will allow you to generate only 100 certificates. If you are a G Suite user, it will allow you to generate 1,500 certificates. It's up to you. Suppose if you are conducting such kind of webinars or FDPs for more than 500 students, only by using a Google ID, you cannot generate certificate for all the 500 participants. You want to have a Google Suite license so that you can create 1,500 certificates with the use of CertifyM. So here we have an advanced tabs. So advanced tabs, you can click it on advanced tab. This loading. So once the person has attended the quiz, the certificate aim will automatically invoke, and it will send a message, that is an email, to the particular respondent with the information: we have received your certificate. The certificate will be sent shortly. Insert other information here. That is, you can also insert other information whichever required here. And what type you have to send, whether the certificate has to be sent as a PDF or it can be sent as an image. So probably we will send all the certificate as the PDF, and where through which we are going to share, we are going to share through email. So you just click on the email. Suppose you just, if you click like a Google Drive, the link for your Google Drive will be sent to the recipient so that they all will access your Google Drive to download the certificate. So better you use the email, you choose the email, and you set the time zone and click on the save changes. Okay, I have changed everything. Now if I'm going to attend the quiz, then automatically what should happen, I have to receive a certificate for that. So everything I have finished here. So just I'm sending it. I'm sending it to. raghavcham@gmail.com. Okay. So body of the mail. And I'm sending it. So once the mail has been sent, I will receive the email for request my account. Inbox. Yes. See, I got the mail. So this is the mail. Click on the button. Google form will get open. Thank you. So I have to fill all the required fields. And then name. College name. Department name. So this is running out of time, so it's not possible to enter all the questions and giving the certificate. I will show you. I have a certificate sample here. So this is the certificate that is automatically generated to the CertifyM. So this is a custom made certificate. I have made this certificate. So this certificate will be sent through email. So you can add everything. You can add the signature at the bottom of the certificate. Everything else you can add it. So this certificate is created with the help of Google Slide. So Google Slide is nothing but just like a PowerPoint presentation. You just design the certificate in the first slide of your PowerPoint and leave it. Don't create another slide with that file. Just create only one slide. It will accept as a certificate. And the last one, the Loom, I just give an insight for the Loom. If you get time, you just go and visit Loom. So Loom is a video recording software for us. It's a video tutorial. It captures the screens and it you can send a video as soon as possible. It is just like sending an email to the students. It will take the same time how you are sending an email. If you are suppose you are using another screen capture tool to record your screen, means it you have to capture it and convert it into video, and you have to upload it in your YouTube, and then that link has to be sent to your students, and then they have to watch. The Loom, what will do is it captures the video and store it in the cloud and directly sends the link to the students. So that the students, when the students click the link, they directly watch the video that was created by the Loom. So here we have an add-on for Chrome. It is only available for Chrome, not other browsers will get supported. So here is a Loom for Chrome. So I have already installed here. You just click on the Loom for Chrome. You just click it on. So recording the Loom. So there are three options, means your video, your face will be shown here. Screen only means screen only recorded. Cam only means camera only recorded. So whatever you want, you can record it. So you just select on what are the choice options you need. You just click on it and start recording. It will get recorded. So it is get recording. So if you want to stop this recording, you just So Loom, I'm sharing the entire content. See, it is asking for, right? So now it is getting recorded. So you can see the recording is happening or not in the icon at the top of the browser. So here is a Loom icon. So it's a red color mark is there. Suppose if you want to stop the video means a stop button, just click on that, it will get stopped. Okay, it is here is a Loom Cloud. It's a video which I have recorded as seen here. You just can see the recording is happening or not in the icon at the top of the browser. So here is a Loom icon. It's a red color mark is there. Suppose if you want to stop the video means recording means you just click on the stop button. Okay, so that's fine. So if you can share the copy the link and you can share it through the WhatsApp or anything else, you can just go. ask the students to view your visit, sorry, see your video and everything else. Okay, that's all now. Thank you for your patient listening. Thank you, my department, for giving me this wonderful opportunity to share my knowledge with the learned persons. If you have any questions, the time permits, I'm ready to answer the questions. Otherwise, I will answer the question and I'll send it to you through the group. Thank you very much.